Welcome to Mrs India 2017, and today I'm with our official image consultant Kavita Joshi. So welcome Kavita, how are you?
Thank you so much.
So, and I think this is not only important in a point of view to beauty pageants, it's for day-to-day life. Nowadays we go out, you know, we join, now the world is like a global village, and then we share so many so many places, we travel so many places. So I think this is not only important as a beauty queen, as an individual, especially you are a very outgoing person, you love to eat so many types of food and love to interact with so many cultures.
Exactly.
This is something I think is very important. So what you have for 2017 in your career?
Yeah, definitely. They are going to represent India abroad, so it's very necessary for them. Because formal situations are always very stressful situations. So you should know what, how to do and how to eat and how to how to hold your glass and how to order etiquette, a lot of other stuff like that that you have to be clever. So definitely that's going to bring out their confidence and they can present themselves more confidently.
So we are going to declutter dining etiquette with Kavita Joshi.
What are the formal settings? How it is done there? You must have heard about 6-course meals, 3-course meals and 4-course meals and all those stuff, right? What happens when you see these kind of settings in front of you, especially in very stressful formal situations? What happens? You keep on thinking, are you kya raha abhi? Kaun sa chamach uthana hai? Kaise pakadna hai? Kaise khana hai? Especially when there is a difficult food like spaghetti and all that. Right? So you should know each and everything, like meat kaise khana hai? Indian food kaise khana hai and at the same time how to eat a continental food, right? So everyone knows this car name, right? BMW.
Yes.
So that's how the place setting is done. So something very simple to remember is BMW. So B stands for the bread plate, M stands for the meal plate, and W stands for wine or a water. So B M W. Everyone say with me.
B M W.
Right? Simple to remember. Right. So that's how the formal setting is done. And the knife and the spoons are on the right side always, and the fork are on the left side because that's how we are going to pick up the knife and fork. That's how it is done. Dessert spoons are always on the top side. Okay. Dessert forks or dessert spoon are always on the top side. And there are a lot of glasses which we are going to see. Each and every glasses is meant for what? Which are the wine glasses, which are the cocktail glasses and everything. Napkins are always, they are kept on the plate or is there, they are some in the maybe in your glass or something. That's it. Now the sitting position. How you should sit. Okay. Generally in a formal situation, avoid sitting cross legs. Why? Because it's kind of barrier when you communicate with someone. So anything comes across your body is as a barrier. That means I don't want to talk to you, or else I'm rigid, I'm not open. That's okay. It's like in formal situations, it's always like a barrier. You should not carry anything when you're talking to someone, not even your hand or something. So better keep your hand on the table because you're starting to eat, not on the elbows only. Because many times it happens, and I mean other people might get discomfortable if you keep your elbows on the table. So avoid elbows on the table, just keep your hand on the table. So that while the conversation is going to happen, you can use your hands well with the words. Then you just open your napkin, okay? Make one fold like this, just one fold, and keep it on your lap. Just like this, so simple, right? And if you want to dab your face, something is there on your face, just you can bring one finger like this and you can dab it and you can keep it again on your lap. Make sure that you should dab it from this side, not from this side. If you are wearing something, again, that is going to spoil. So always make an index finger, just dab it and put it on your lap. There are two more uses of napkin. One is to dab your mouth, okay?
The second thing is signaling your waiter. If you have some calls, it's important calls, and you have to take the call, or else you have to go for the washroom. You just say to your guest, okay, just excuse me, I want to go somewhere. And when you will put your napkin on the chair. Why? Because the wait staff will understand this person is going to come. Otherwise, your fancy meal is all gone.
Knives. Forks are always kept on the left side. Knives are on the right side.
So this is the way. You have to take the fork on your left side. Try to balance it on your index finger. We are going to practice it, so don't worry. So try to balance it on your index finger like this. Then grab it. Just like a pen, okay? And slice your meal, not cut your meal like this, but slice it like this, a little bit tilted, so that you will get a nice chunk of food. And then you have to grab the food and then eat it like this. The spoon should always come to you. You should not go to your meal or spoon, okay? The spoon should come to you always. So this is the better position. If you keep your elbows like this, what will happen? Okay, you're not able to eat it properly. So your elbows should be always in line so that it's a good distance to eat basically. There is a resting position and there is a finished position. You can make it through your knife and fork. So what is the resting position? Again, you have to go out for some call or some washroom or something. Then you have to keep it like this. Okay? The sharp side should be inside like this and the fork should be on this. So it's a cross. Don't worry, I'm going to show you here. I'm going to call one by one so that in a group maybe, so that we can.